Rudy Giuliani, who is already under criminal investigation and at risk of losing his law license, is now also getting sued by his former attorney for failing to pay over $1 million worth of legal fees. Making matters worse, the individual who has decided to sue him is a longtime friend of his. We'll get to that in just a moment. But the lawyer, Robert J. Costello, who had been leading Giuliani's defense against an onslaught of legal woes, signed on to the lawsuit brought by his firm on Monday to recover more than $1.3 million in unpaid legal fees. In all, Costello's firm has billed Giuliani more than $1.5 million, according to the lawsuit. Of that, Giuliani has paid only $214,000, most recently handing over a measly $10,000 just last week. Now, according to multiple people with knowledge of the situation, Giuliani owes quite a bit of money. In fact, he owes nearly $3 million to various law firms, including the one where Costello is a partner. Giuliani had repeatedly sought a financial lifeline from his client, Donald Trump, who had offered vague promises to pay up, but had largely refused to do so. Now, Trump, of course, is notorious for not paying his bills, which is part of the reason why he has gone bankrupt 6 separate times. But Trump also has his own legal bills to worry about. And on top of that, he did offer to help to some extent. So Trump's Political Action Committee did recently pay off more than $300,000 that Giuliani owed to a different company. And Trump hosted a fundraiser for Giuliani's legal defense fund. So there is some assistance, want to be fair and mention those things. But much of what Giuliani owes from his work is from his work essentially challenging the results of the 2020 presidential election. He racked up legal bills while battling criminal and congressional investigations, private lawsuits, and also disciplinary proceedings. Costello's law firm, Davidoff Hutcher and Citron, worked on his now closed foreign lobbying federal criminal investigation, the January 6th related investigations by Georgia state prosecutors, the House of Representatives and the Federal Special Counsel's Office, and in various lawsuits and attorney discipline probes that materialized after the 2020 election, according to a complaint filed in New York State court on Monday. So before we get into the frenemy situation that Giuliani now finds himself in, what do you think, Cenk?
Okay, so Trump did help a little bit. I mentioned on another show that where we covered that story, but it's about 10% of his bills. So I guess if I'm Rudy, I'm like, I'll take it, but it's just not gonna get the job done. So if you owe a couple of $1 million, you're still owed a couple million bucks, and that's not easy to get past. So as I look at Rudy, now every time I see a picture of him or a video of him, he looks like two things to me, if I'm being honest. One is just a totally broken man. And if you didn't live in New York, you might not have, or you weren't paying careful attention to politics, you might not have a sense of how much Rudy Giuliani was revered after 9/11. I mean, he was called America's mayor and people meant it and they loved him. They loved him in New York and Republicans loved him all across the country. And so he didn't help himself afterwards. And by the way, was that earned? I could argue that it wasn't, okay? So he has a complicated history. Some of it is pretty decent. The 9/11 response was good in a lot of ways. He put the Center for Response and the World Trade Center, which made no sense. I can go on and on about the things he did wrong and a couple of things he did right. But as I look at him now, it's hard not to feel not empathy, but as a progressive, I feel some degree of sympathy for this obviously broken man. Now his friends are suing him. He's begging Trump on a daily basis. Trump is giving him the crumbs off the table. He's broke. He's just, and he might go to jail soon.
What I want to know is, does Rudy Giuliani have a single family member who gives a damn about him, right?
Because, and that's another thing that's really sad, because that's such a good point.
Right, if you was my father, for instance, I actually don't know about his family situation. I don't know how many kids he has, but doesn't matter. If that were my father, right, if I saw him aligning himself with nefarious figures, if I saw him basically threatening his future with all sorts of liabilities and all sorts of, I'd put him in a headlock, okay, gentle headlock though. I don't want to cause too much damage. And I'd lock him in a basement and I'd be like, Dad, it's over, okay? No more public life. You are going to destroy everything you have worked for your entire life. And it just shocks me that it seems like not a single family member of his is stepping in to say, hey, you need to relax, okay? This is bad and you're destroying everything for yourself.
And look, even the Republicans and people very close to Trump confirmed that he's got a drinking problem, right? And so you add that to the mix, and then we know what happens, guys. Fame warps not just you, but everything around you. So he does have a son. His son was trying to milk
that's
him.
Right.
So, I'm famous. I'm Rudy Giuliani's son, and he ran for political office.
I forgot about that.
And he was clown extraordinaire, and he's been a clown his whole life, right? And so instead of helping his dad, he's trying to milk off his dad.
It's disgusting.
It's just gross in every way. And then another thing is he's got the hunch now. And I'm gonna be a little bit of a jerk here, but he reminds me a little bit of a broken penguin. Like Kingpin has won the bad guy things. You know, I'm combining Spider-Man and Batman here. But and
poor
like
penguins.
Penguin works for Kingpin, and he's like, right? And like things are dripping down his face. And he also kind of looks like Igor working for, you know, and Frankenstein's running around, and there's Igor going, help me, right?
God,
and
disaster.
So it is. It's an epic disaster. It's story of not America's decline, but an American's decline, and we've all seen it right in front of our eyes. But at the same time, it's hard to have sympathy when this guy was part of the team that tried to do a coup against America. From hero on 9/11 to doing a fake elector plot where you would overturn the presidential election and have the guy that you know lost the election be crowned as the winner and destroy our democracy, destroy the idea of America. Sorry, Igor, but that's what you get.
Now, finally, let's get to the relationship, the personal relationship he had with Costello, which has now been destroyed. So the two men have actually known each other for like half a century, 50 years. Costello trained as a law student under Giuliani, who at the time was a federal prosecutor in Manhattan, and they became friends. For the last 4 years, Costello was a loyal defender of Giuliani's, both on an attorney-client basis, but also publicly. And in a statement, Giuliani decided to essentially lash out at him and say that he's pretty much hurt over this lawsuit. He says, "I can't express how personally hurt I am by what Bob Costello has done. It's a real shame when lawyers do things like this. And all I will say is that their bill is way in excess of anything approaching legitimate fees." Now, Costello initially declined to comment, but after Giuliani had put out that statement, he decided to respond. And here's what he said. "How can he take a personal affront when he owes my firm nearly $1.4 million? And look, that's 100% true. This is why you probably should not engage in any business with friends and family. Like I think most of the time it's a bad idea. Very rare instances it doesn't fall apart, right? In this case, it fell apart. And so he's absolutely right. It's not just about Costello. This is his firm. Okay, there are other lawyers, there are other people that they've billed 1.4 million and Giuliani has failed to pay up.
Yeah.
So
look, part of me says no honor among thieves. I mean, if you ask your friend to represent you, you ran up a giant legal bill. So now you're catching feelings that he's gonna charge you. Did you think that he was just gonna let $1.4 million go and everybody at his firm was gonna let it go? And then to his so-called friend, did you think Rudy was gonna pay you? You don't see him both as a friend and as a client. You don't see him falling apart at the seams. So you thought you were gonna get paid. You thought he was gonna get the money from who? Donald Trump? Oh, and now you're upset that you're not getting the money from Trump and Rudy. Color me surprised. And so if you thought you were gonna get that money, you're a bit of an idiot. So I don't have a lot of sympathy for you either. Okay, so the thieves are turning on each other. So final thing here is, guys, when people make the turn, Liz Cheney on drawing the line and saying, no, I might be Darth Vader's protege, but I still believe in the country and I don't want to end democracy. And Mike Pence saying similar things. It doesn't mean we love Cheney and Pence. It doesn't mean all is forgiven. It doesn't mean you should vote for either one of them. But it does mean that's when we show some degree of grace and mercy.
Mm-hmm.
So if Rudy ever flips on Trump and he means it and he's honest finally, then that's when we should show him mercy. But But as I write in Justice Coming, no mercy until you win.
No cookies for you.
Yeah, no cookies for you. If you're still going around going, well, it'd be great if we just got rid of democracy. It'd be great if Trump won and he pardoned all of us and we went back to being the dictators that we want to be and take away all your freedoms and rights. No deal, Rudy, no deal at all. But if you actually come to your senses, then yes, I think we should help him because he's not just broke, he is a broken man. If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.